Hello everyone, my name is Vera Sosnovik. Today I'm going to present our paper, Understanding the Complexity of Detecting Political Ads. The motivation for this work is that online political advertising has grown significantly during the last years. During the 2020 US presidential elections, 18% of political marketing spending went to online advertising, compared to 3% in 2016 and 1.5% in 2012. However, as you probably heard from news media, there were several issues in the past years related to online political advertising. The first case is the Cambridge Analytica data scandal. Cambridge Analytica used the data to provide analytical assistance to the 2016 presidential campaign of Ted Cruz and Donald Trump. What they are known for is that they targeted political ads based on people's personality. And here you can see some examples. Another case is the Russian Internet Research Agency sent several ads before the 2016 US elections that we know were on polarizing topics that were targeted precise group of people such as African Americans and Latinos. To be able to monitor sponsored political ads, companies such as Facebook, Google, Twitter, and TikTok try to regulate political advertising. For example, Facebook allows political ads, but advertisers have to verify their accounts and have to self-label their political ads. The advertisers can only send political ads in the country they reside. Google, as well as Facebook, allows political ads, but advertisers can only use geographic location, age, gender, and contextual targeting to target political ads. On the contrary, Twitter and TikTok ban all political advertising. Moreover, government on their side, working on the Digital Services Act and the European Democracy Action Plan. Both pieces of work will contain parts about online political ads regulation. In a recent interview, Vera Jourova, the Vice President of the European Commission, was saying that they seriously considered to restrict micro-targeting of political ads. This is great, but it seems that everyone makes the underlying assumption that we know which ads are political and which are not. But the question is, can we reliably distinguish political ads from non-political ads? Now I'm going to provide example of ads that confuse me. First example is, Christians around the world are suffering for their faith, and there is a critical need for Bibles to help them stay strong. Help us meet our goal to reach 10,150 persecuted Christians with God's word and training to disciple more believers. Another example is help us force company to stop the destruction of rainforest caused by the production of palm oil. Greenpeace will see to it that companies keep their promises to use only palm oil that doesn't come at the cost of cleaning forest. And final example, if socialism is really so great, why don't socialist professors teach for free? All three ads do not have a message that clearly related to the elections, but at the same time, I can't say that these ads are not political. We take an empirical approach to test the assumption by analyzing if people agree on what ads are political. Next, analyzing the characteristic of ads considered political by ordinary people, and analyzing the characteristic of ads that lead to disagreement. Let's start from the first question. Do platforms agree what ads are political? Facebook defines political ads as ads made by, on behalf or about a candidate for public office, political actors ads, about any election, referendum, and etc. We are going to call them elections ads. About social issues like civil and social rights, crime, economy, and etc. in any place where the ads is being published. Social issue ads. However, platforms do not have consensus. Twitter and Google do not consider social issue ads as political, while Facebook and Twitter does. Our next question is, do users agree on what ads are political? To study it, we analyze a data set from ProPublica. ProPublica is an investigative journalism organization that has developed a browser extension that is collecting the ads people are receiving on Facebook and allows user, wherever the ads they are seeing, labeled as political or not. Dataset contains labels from volunteers, users who label the ads, and advertisers. By label from advertisers, we mean paid for by disclaimer that Facebook obliged advertisers to put on their political ads. We analyzed 55,000 ads with at least 3 volunteer votes. To find out, do volunteers agree which ads are political, we calculated the fraction of political votes for the ads. According to the fraction, we divided ads from ProPublica into 4 categories. The first one is strong political ads. Volunteers agree that these ads are political. Next, political ads. The fraction of political votes is less than 1, but more or equal to 0.5. Marginal political ads. The fraction of political votes is more than 0, but less than 0.5. And non-political ads. Volunteers agree that this ad is not political. We can see that there is more than 50% of ads where at least one volunteer disagrees with each other. To understand do volunteers and advertisers agree, let's look at the table. We call ads that have a paid for by disclaimer the official political ads, and the ones that do not have not official political ads. And on the left column, we have labels from volunteers. For strong, 4% of strong political ads and 7% of political ads were not labeled as political by advertisers. And 74% of marginal political ads and 100% of not political ads were not labeled as political by volunteers. However, many ads considered by advertisers are not regarded as political by volunteers. Next, we wanted to understand the characteristic of ads labeled as political. First, we decided to look at advertisers' category. When advertisers create a page, they have to select a category for their page from predefined list. We extracted categories for 82% of advertisers, and similar categories were grouped together. We find out that most strong political ads come from political actors. In political ads group and marginal political ads group, most ads come from NGOs. Official political ads has a wide variety of advertisers. A vast range of advertisers are pushing political ads online, and volunteers label ads as political from a diverse set of advertisers. That means that specific electoral legislation should not regulate ads only from political actors, as some countries do. If you are curious to see what ads were labeled as political, here is an example. The ice cream company Ben & Jerry is insisting citizens to vote. Next, Center for Reproductive Rights, non-government organization, is addressing straight advocacy messages about abortion issue. Finally, World Food Program, a charity, is addressing social issue, but do not seem to have any evidence association to election or legislation. The second characteristic that we want to explore is ad messages. To do it, we set up experiment on Prolific. We took a random sample of 300 ads with paid for by disclaimer and 300 ads without paid for by disclaimer from the strong political ads, and marginal political ads. Moreover, we took 300 ads from non-political ads and 200 ads without disclaimer from a Adanalyst dataset. Adanalyst is a Chrome extension that collects ads from the Facebook timeline. Each worker has to label 20 random ads. For each ad, we ask the following questions. Is this ad made on behalf or about political actor? Is this ad about elections? Does this ad refer to a social issue? If workers select that ad is about social issue, we ask them which social issue is this ad talking about. Workers had to choose an answer from the predefined list. We attribute all ads about both a political figure and a social issue, or a political figure and election to the political figure group, and all ads both an election and a social issue to the election group. There are many ads about political actors and elections from strong political and political group. But we find out that the large fraction of ads from political and strong political groups are about social issue, and these ads do not mention political figures or election. Hence, it's crucial to consider ads about social issue as political. Our result also showed that a wide range of ads are getting labeled as ads about social issue. Hence, since many legislative projects are considered to severely restrict micro-targeting or ban such ads altogether, we need to decide wherever we want ads with no apparent link to election or legislation coming from charities or communities, to be subject to the same restriction as that advocate polarizing issue. Such a restriction could hurt a wide range of humanitarian and civil organizations. What we can learn from the disagreement? Two main factors contribute to disagreement between advertisers and volunteers. First, volunteers underreport ads about social issue, and advertisers underreport ads about social issue. Part of the problem may be that the definition of ads about social issue is too broad, which leads to different interpretation among people. Another reason, advertisers mislabel ads as political or non-political. Maybe to avoid scrutiny, or maybe because they are forced to label the ads as political by enforcement mechanism put in place by ad platforms. To wrap everything up, there are a lot of disagreement between platforms, advertisers, and volunteers. Large portion of ads volunteers labeled as political are about social issue, and we need to consider this as political, but social issue ads create confusion between volunteers and advertisers. That leads us to many questions. Should we treat ads about more politicized issue differently than ads about less politicized issue? Should we treat ads that call for precise action differently than ads that just inform citizens? And how much weight should be given to the advertiser's identity? Thank you for your attention.